I think it's safe to say that anybody who's ever played Minecraft multiplayer has heard about duels. It's a pretty self-explanatory game mode. Two players go into a 1v1, and whoever kills the other player wins the duel. I was looking at Hypixel's take on duels and wondering how difficult it must be to make something like that. So I did exactly what every sane person would do. I learned how to code! Hey guys, X-Force here. So you might be a little bit confused on what's going on in this video. And yeah, so am I. 2 weeks ago, I took on a challenge to try and learn Java. It's a coding language essentially with which you can make plugins and stuff. It's a really nice language. Anyways, with that, I made my own plugin and yeah, I'm gonna show you guys it now. Alright, so we are now on our server. The scoreboard is something that I've also made myself, which I think is rather cool looking. Anyways, so we've got this little area right here. I don't have a hub as of yet because I'm kind of lacking builders. But considering the server is not even open at all times anyways right now, that's not really a problem. It's more about learning how to make the plugin. So if you look at a Minecraft server, there's a lot more behind this than you could imagine. So as a plugin maker, as somebody who creates a server, you actually need to think of a lot of stuff. You need to think of, yeah, mostly what players could do that could ruin your plugin. Say if someone were to jump off the platform, they would need to be revived in this world. They would need to be revived, sent back to spawn, all that kind of stuff. Like if people were to try and break blocks, and that people won't lose hunger, all that stuff. Yeah, essentially, upon right-clicking the compass, the lobby selector right here, you can get this menu right here, and you can join duels, or you can click on the stained glass pane and nothing will happen. Yeah, you can join duels, and then you get sent to the duels lobby, the very nice lobby once again. Yeah, once again, we don't really need that. And then you get two items in your inventory, the join queue item and the back to main lobby item. Essentially, back to main lobby just sends you over here, and then the join queue opens this menu in which you can select different types of duels. Currently, I've only got Build UHC, and Build UHC will put you in a queue for Build UHC. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and open my alt account because I want to get like another account on here so that I can actually show off the duels plugin. Because obviously, that's kind of the main part of this. Right, I've now joined my alt account. The alt account has joined the server. Let's see, let's send that guy to the duels lobby as well. And we're gonna join Build UHC on this account. You can also see that on the sidebar, right here, the player count actually changes to two players, which is really nice. And when my alt account leaves the server, it also changes to one player. Anyways, let's let my alt account join the Build UHC queue. So then you can see that we get sent to a temporary lobby. This is not a lobby that's going to be used, but I just built this to make things easy. And like you can see the title screen popping up. You can also see the title command, but you don't normally see that as a player. And then essentially, I cannot even break blocks in this. I cannot break blocks in this lobby, which is really nice. I can, however, break blocks if they are placed by a player. So that is really, really nice. Like that is, I'm really a big fan of this. Like I'm a big fan of how I've managed to do things so far. They spawned with full prot 1 diamond out of prot 1 chain helmet, clean diamond sword, clean bow, fishing rod, 16 arrows, 3 golden heads, 6 scapples, a lava bucket, a water bucket, and another water bucket, and then 2 stacks of blocks, pickaxe, and an axe. All just in these slots for now. And honestly, the best thing about this all is the G-heads. I love them. That was so nice to code. It's so nice. You cannot place G-heads. I'll show you guys. You cannot place them on blocks like that, but you can eat them. And you get regen 2 for 10 seconds, speed for 10 seconds, and absorption for 2 minutes. And then you can't place them, but there is a delay on eating them. There's a 5 second delay on eating them so that you can't double eat the heads, which is just really nice. There have been glitches in the past, like for example, when a player died to lava and they get sent to spawn, they used to not actually be able to respawn properly and they would still be on fire, but I've actually managed to glitch that. And as you can see, another title screen pops up, a command gets broadcasted, a message gets broadcasted over the entire server saying that I've won the duel. I'm honestly so proud of myself for this, but what I want to do is I want to test this out with some of you guys because I already know that most of the stuff is working properly, but I really want to know that, like, you know, everything is fine and that there's no real huge bugs to this. Because, you know, there are some things that I haven't tested out yet that might actually be of a big deal. currently, of course, there's no stats and everything yet. Like, that's pretty advanced to be able to make. Yeah, I'll be doing a live stream tomorrow at 9 p.m. my time. I'll put, like, other time zones on the screen right now. But essentially, if you want to join the dual server, then you can do that then. It's literally just to test out things. I'm going to have some fun times with everybody. So, yeah, I'm kind of hoping to see you guys all there. It's really excited because this is really exciting for me. It's weird to have made my own plugin and to be using that exact plugin right now. Like, it's insane to be able to do this like that. Like, making my own G-heads and stuff, making the armor, making the arena, fixing bugs, it's something so nice. Like, I'm so happy with how this is all going, so yeah. Yeah, anyways, this was Perforce. This is the whole project that I was talking about earlier that I was working on. And for those of you that don't think this is intriguing, it's a lot of work, alright? Learning how to code and learning everything, like, within a time span of 2 weeks with, like, school and everything, it's difficult. It's very difficult. Yeah, anyways, I really hope I can see you guys all tomorrow in the stream. Anyways, guys, have a good rest of your day. See you in the next one. Peace.